So now that we've looked at a light, I'm going to look at a character. Characters can be a little bit tricky. This is a really cute little witch person, and she's great, but she takes up 33% of the graphics thermometer, so that maybe doesn't leave a whole lot of room for her to have a nice world to walk around in. So we can tidy that up a little bit. So again, I'm going to just copy one for reference. I'm going to rotate this around a little bit so I can see her better. This is not all one object right now, and I'm going to want to get rid of it later. So I'm going to group, and then I'm going to go into my tools, and I'm going to freeze just that one for reference, and go to the sculpture detail. And now this is something that might be confusing. You see this little bow on here, that's bright red, so it looks like we should be able to reduce the detail on that. However, it's actually not a sculpt, that's a painting. And you can't reduce sculpture detail on a painting. So just to avoid any sort of confusion, I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna hide paint because there's nothing I can do for that with the sculpture tool anyway. And now I'm just not gonna see that little bow and it won't be confusing at all. So now we're looking at her. She's actually mostly blue except for right around the eyes. And really, we're not going to be able to take a lot of detail out of the eyes because that's so important for the character and it's such small, thin shapes. So we're going to try to reduce just a little bit in the middle of the eye and then just a little bit on the eyelid. There we go. We saw a little bit of a change there. And now I'm just going to use the undo and redo function to sort of look for changes. And I'm not seeing changes there in the eyelid or the eye, but if we go in and we try and take it down any farther, it's going to start to get rough. So now we're seeing a little bit of roughness on the edge of the eyelid. Probably not so much that we'd notice it from a difference, or from a, not so much that we would notice it from a distance. And maybe we can actually take one more click out of the eyeball center and one or two out of the edge of the eye. Now, see, that's not looking so good. When I back up, it looks clearer, so we're going to just go back and leave that because we don't want to mess with her eyes too much. So that's not going to take out a lot of detail. All right, so the next most red area on this little witch is the hair and also the tip of the hat. The tip of the hat is not really going to optimize very well because it's so thin and so pointy. If we start taking detail out of that, see, we're losing the end of that hat really quickly. So I'm going to back up and we're just going to leave that alone. Same thing with the brim of the hat. It's already blue, but it's so thin. If we start to reduce the detail there, look, it starts to become see-through a little bit there. And that's not good either. So we're just going to leave the hat alone completely. And we'll get in on the hair here, because I think we can take a little bit out of the hair. We'll just start taking it down, try and get that to where it's blue, and then see how it looks. I just saw a little change in the tip of the hairs there. So I'll just go and sort of undo and redo and leave it at that. And now the hair is actually two different sculpts, so now this one is more pink and we'll just make it the same blue as the rest of the hair, and then it should all be the same detail, and that'll be okay. And then the bangs we can do also to match the rest in detail. Well, they have a little bit more detail, so that'll have to stay just a little bit more pink. And comparing side by side, they look the same. Still, it looks just fine. So the other places that we can take out is, looks like now the shoes are the next biggest. And this is underneath the character. It's on the ground all the time. You could actually probably take a lot of detail out of the shoes and not really notice too much. That's looking maybe just a little bit fuzzy on the right. It's just a little bit too much. Go back maybe a couple and do the other one. Oops, I've gone too far. So if you get in really close, you can see a difference, but you're never really going to look at the character's feet up this close, probably. You're going to see it from up here, and it'll look fine. The coat is not too highly detailed, but it's a very dark, matte finish, which means we can take quite a bit of detail out of it. So let's just take some out of the sleeves for starters, and a little bit out of the bag. The button on the bag has this little X on it, and I'm guessing if we start to decrease that too much, we're going to lose the detail there. very quickly, so we want to leave that as it is. The button itself, if we take out the detail, that's also is, it's so small and it's not taking up a lot anyway. We want to keep that nice shine on there, so we'll leave that as it is. Just keep moving on and doing the bag strap and a little bit on the staff. And this sleeve over here can come down. The whole body of the cloak is not taking up a lot, but it also could even be a little bit cheaper. So we'll take it down to there. And backing up and redoing, you can see a little bit of change in texture. But when you look at the original and the optimized one side by side, they're still looking pretty darn close. So let's see what happens now if we unfreeze and delete the original one. So now we're down to 14%, and she was at 33, I think, when we started. So that's a pretty good start. And you could even keep going with this a little bit if you wanted to, but that's made a pretty big change. And characters can be really tricky because you don't want to lose face detail, but on the other hand, you don't want your character taking up so much thermometer space that you don't have room for a level for them to live in.